I'm getting positive feedback about your work. And your next gig tests the notion that rock and roll never dies. We have four fried musicians, and I don't mean drug burnouts, electrocuted. They were shooting a reality TV show at the casino. Our Vicks seem to be well past their 15 minutes of fame, but even stale celebrities freshly dead attract media. So we can't hit any wrong notes on this one. Follow Warwick Brown's lead, and you'll stay right in tune.
Hearing good things about you. Let's roll and rock. Bullet Train, 80s band, big hair and wild threads and a couple of hits. I guess we know the answer to whatever happened to... Okay, that's Boogie Feet Brown on lead guitar, Marty Party on bass, Stevie Olacek down off his drum kit. But this young singer must be a replacement. Like Elvis C says, accidents can happen, particularly around electronic gear like this. So can murder.
Huh? Me? I'm nobody. Just the sound tech. Todd Hinckley. Yeah, we were doing a sound check for our TV show when something malfunctioned. I mean, really malfunctioned. I hope it's nothing I did.
I hope so too, Todd.
Yeah, well, back at the soundboard, of course. The train, they were going into their big finale. The guys come in and share the mic with our lead singer, you know, for that last killer chord. Oh, sorry. Bad choice of words.
You think?
God, I think I'm gonna be sick. It was horrible, man. One minute they're rocking out, the next, frying. Bullet Train to Bad Street. Maybe you remember, that was the name of the train's first album, Bad Street USA. Reality show based around the guys auditioning a new lead singer. Find just the right young chick with the moves and the pipes and, you know, really hot. Tomorrow was supposed to be the finale. Down to two contestants. Yeah, Andrea Stevenson, one of the two finalists. Really talented, and the guys liked her. But some of us think that the other contender, Kathy Cantanta, was the real deal. And Kathy? Well, she had the fan support. Fierce? Well, that's a harsh word. I mean, sure, they both want to win, but they get along. Or got along. I mean, hell, they've been rooming together next door since the beginning of the competition. The show put them up in a huge luxury suite, part of that reality TV drama, I guess.
How long have you known these guys?
Hey, I'm a pro, and the trainer pros. Of course, you get to know people you're working with on the road, day in, day out, or on a big production like this. I know Kathy better than Andrea. Her, I was still getting to know. Oh my God, what a waste. I've been with Bullet Train since, like, forever. I dropped out of high school to roadie for them. I mean, what the hell am I gonna do now?
Barefoot on a metal stage. Points for showmanship, not for common sense. Electric guitars, mics, and no insulation. Playing barefoot, current grounded itself in zap, our probable cause of death. Dressed for the show, black leather jackets, jeans, and their trademark belt buckles. Vocal effects pedal. You don't see these often. Looks like it connects to that mic on the ground. Nice catch. Pedal's sure to screw. Let's have a close-up look back at the lab. This is the mic they were holding. Could this be where the current started? That is one ugly bug. Go ahead and grab it for Grissom. The plug that connects the grounding wire has been removed. Unsafe stage practice, but not necessarily sabotage. Arodeos sometimes cut these off to fit into different outlets. You'll want a different tool for that. Who was it that sang "Die with Your Boots On"? This video camera is online. Perfect view of the stage.
Well, yeah, I was taping too. That's part of the run-through. But I can't give that to you guys. Eddie, my boss, he nixed giving that out to anybody. You know how the media would run with it.
Todd, we're not the media. We're the law. And your set is now our crime scene. And everything from busted drumsticks to guitar picks and duct tape to that videotape is evidence.
Right. I'm not trying to hassle you, honest. Here you go. It was a signature thing. Original singer, she never wore shoes. Wild child kind of deal. So her tryout replacements did the same. The boys, they always wore cowboy boots, but they got kidding around and took them off as a show of solidarity that Andrea was their personal choice, not Kathy.
Why is the power cord missing the plug that connects it to the grounding wire?
I didn't know it was. You see, we've been playing a lot of small clubs. The train's on the comeback road, you know? So sometimes you cut off those thingies to be able to plug it in at all. But I thought before this big gig, we'd weeded out all that small crap. I don't do that stuff. Never did, really. I'm strictly into the music, not the pharmaceutical perks. I mean, the guys are really into the music, sure, of course, but, well, you know how rockers are. They do like to party.
That's me. Listen, I of course heard what happened, and I'm just devastated. I feel like I lost my best friends. I'll try to answer your questions, but you have to understand, this is such an awful, awful tragedy. Losing these great rock stars is a real blow to music. And of course, Andrea, too. Okay, I knew you'd ask that question, and I've been trying to think how to tell you, how to convince you that, yes, we're contestants, finalists, but we'd been through a lot, all the early rounds of the show, and we really, really were friends. Anyway, on these kinds of shows, the runner-up often does better than the winner.
So it wouldn't bother you if you did better, but she won.
Of course it would break my heart, but I would really be glad for her. She's worked so hard. Oh, this is awful. Now I feel like everyone else who says it like they've been brainwashed, but I mean it, I've come this far. It's been the opportunity of a lifetime. Just getting the chance to play with those guys was a dream come true. Oh, well, it used to be all of the contestants. So many talented singers, so much great energy. But now it's just the two of us. Or one. God. I'd like to help, but I just can't think of anything else right now.
Nicknamed Boogie Feet, age 52, arrested for willful destruction of property, theft, and reckless endangerment for sneaking an ostrich into his hotel room. Interesting. Boogie Feet Brown steps on the vocal pedal, not Andrea. And the current hits. Andrea's mic went through that echo pedal. So when Boogie Feet punched the pedal, the switch inside reversed the electric current. It couldn't ground itself via the power cord. Instead, it grounded with the stage, killing off four of them. There's more to be done with that item before we can process it. You'll want a different tool for that. Close. Try using a similar tool. You'll want a different tool for that. You know, I hang around with enough music pals to know that there are effects pedals for all kinds of purposes, but not a switch designed to reverse the current when stepped on. print belongs to Steven Olacek, nicknamed Stevie, age 49, arrested for trespassing and public indecency at the Newport Aquarium. Marty Party, age 57, arrested for stealing a hot air balloon.
Sure, I'll send a team right out. Well, if you're expecting a big revelation, I can't help you. Electrocution is indeed the cause of death for all four DOAs. I admit, beautiful young women are my least favorite clients. And this is a real waste of youth and talent. Tox screen, clean. I've got a fingerprint for you, and that's all. Sure thing. I'll prepare the body. Even before that current made him a permanent has-been, Marty's party was winding down. You could run a pharmacy for a week with what this bassist had in him. Records show he was intimate with a stomach pump, and his alcohol content could have got him pulled over for walking without a license. One peculiar note, Marty also suffered from jock itch. Found a nearly empty tube of antifungal cream in his pocket. It's on the side table there if you'd like to take a look. Sure thing. I'll prepare the body. Too bad he boogied with his bare feet and not in his boots. Electrocution occurs when the current runs through the body into the ground. Rubber-soled shoes act as an insulator between the body and the ground. But Arvik's went out of the world the way they came in, unshod. Sure thing. I'll prepare the body. Traces of alcohol, cocaine, and a long list of pharmaceuticals, none of which impacted COD. Those marks are a classic case of ringworm. Some people mistake it for real worms, but it's just a good old-fashioned fungus. Stevie appeared to be treating it with a spray powder, hence the whiteness around the area. Eerie, isn't it? Lichtenberg figures, they're called. Pretty common in such cases.
You can't be serious. Wasn't this an accident? Who could want something like this to happen?
The evidence indicates that this was no accident.
Oh my God! You can't mean this. You really can't. Isn't it bad enough, this tragedy, without suggesting somebody'd want to hurt those wonderful people? You must be wrong. Your evidence, you need to check it again or something. Look around? Well, sure, I guess. Will that help?
Stop screwing with him or else. I guess this could be taken a couple of ways. Nice work. It looks like an email Todd sent to Andrea. Encrypted, but not for long. Whoa. As a computer artist, Todd's right in there with the wackos pasting their photos in the magazine shots of movie stars they want to marry. You'll want a different tool for that. We make a great couple. Love, Todd. No wonder she encrypted this email. Stalker, maybe? Nice work.
Todd was at the scene, had the opportunity, certainly the know-how, and now we find he was the one-man fan club of the female victim, who may have been sleeping with everybody but him. Motive enough for me. Let's bring him in. You had a favorite in the competition, didn't you, Todd? Andrea. Tell us about that.
Well, what's to tell? We just hit it off during the run of the show. Happened to have some real chemistry, her and me. Not that it was serious. You know how showbiz is. All flings and no relationships. Yeah, you know, nothing major.
With such a minor fling, it must have slipped your mind when we spoke earlier. Beautiful, talented young women on the way to the top. Always head straight for the roadies, right, Todd? Who needs a rock star when you're around, is that it?
I'm a sound tech, not a roadie. I told you before about wearing two hats, but I've been with Train a long time. I'm a major part of the band. And when Andrea won, she would have made changes. I wouldn't be stuck behind the scenes anymore if she had her way. She would have... what the hell's the difference? She's dead. Bullet train's over, end of track, next song.
Maybe you found out she was only stringing you on. Or maybe you imagined the whole relationship. And maybe... you sent Bullet Train to rock and roll heaven.
What the hell do you know about it? Bullet Train, those great guys, they were everything in my life. They were my life. For almost 20 years, thick and thin, I was there for them. You talk to Eddie Tillis. He might have wanted this to happen. Not me, not me. Some detectives, their damn manager. And an executive producer on the TV series is all. Lately, for the show, Train recorded some great new tunes, really killer stuff. But Eddie claimed to own exclusive rights to the new tunes, because under the TV contract, they were part of the show. Eddie and the guys, they got into some real hot and heavies. More than once, the boys threatened to fire his ass. It's, the singer's pedal. I mean, what's to know? Is this a trick question?
You see this switch? Someone put it inside to reverse the current when it stepped on.
Reverse the current? Yeah, but that would cause the... Oh my God! Me? No. It wasn't me. I checked it, and everything was fine. I am sure I checked it.
You saying someone else around here has the technical chops to rig this?
Well, they must have. I didn't do it. Nobody else comes to mind. If I think of anybody, I'll let you know.
Yes, I am. And you would be?
Warwick Brown, and this is my partner. We're investigators with the Las Vegas Crime Lab, and we're looking into the bullet train fatalities.
Does the crime lab usually look into accidental deaths? Or is it just because this involves celebrities and was a tad on the bizarre side?
Bizarre, all right, but no accident. This was murder, and we need to talk to you about it.
Murder? My God, my band is murdered and no one even informs me? Here I've been all day working on a press release about the accident, and I have to start the hell over. Like my time isn't worth a diddly damn. God. Are you kidding me? Do you know a single damn thing about Bullet Train? They were the original bad boys who grew up to be horrible boys. Enemies? Try every concert promoter and hotel manager in Western Europe, Japan, and the good old US of A. Then there's Australia. Those scamps managed to get themselves deported 2 weeks into a three-month tour. Andrea? Not really. She knew how to handle the boys. And you know how those contestants are, going out of their way to make everybody like them. Todd. Oh, yeah. He's the original Nebbish. It's true. The guy was the band's doormat. They banished him from the bus for some imagined infraction. And the poor jerk had to hitchhike 40 miles to the next gig, and yet he still showed on time. Dirty, starving, and exhausted, but right there for the guys. Oh, by the way, you know how they repaid him for his loyalty? They let him ride in the bus on the next leg in the luggage compartment. And how did he stand up to him? He didn't. He worshiped those clowns. Hey. I don't mind you investigating this thing, accident or murder or whatever the hell you want to call it, but you stay out of my business. I don't know who's talking out of turn, but, well, look, it's true. We had our share of bumps, the boys and me, okay? But they're poster children of spoiled, stupid rock stars. When I took them on, they were playing nostalgia venues, and now I had them poised for a real comeback. They try to stick it to me? But I've been in this business a long time, and I knew what I was getting into. They didn't appreciate what I did for them, but I didn't expect them to. Yeah, right. Let me tell you something, guys. The train fired me last week, twice, and at least once a week since I signed with them. They were dumb, but they knew I was their lifeline. Look, but don't touch. I'm standing in the eye of a media hurricane, and I don't need the grief. You want more? I want a warrant.
Demos. Possibly the songs the band and their manager were squabbling over. Kathy seems to be the only singer on these tracks. This memo is from the network. It's dated 1 month ago. They warn that continued decline in the show's ratings have caused concern and that any future projects between the network and Eddie's production company have been put on hold pending the outcome of the show's finale. They outline some changes they want, including fixing the results so that Andrea will win the competition. Looks like Eddie was under some pressure from the TV execs. We'll need a warrant to take this.
Hey, what's up? He's on his way to interrogation now.
Well, sure, I mean, you know, they picked on me, but it was always in fun. They know I work hard for them, and they're still just kids at heart. Just encouraging me to lighten up about things. They never meant any harm by it.
Exact match on the flame retardants. Must be from the same batch of chemicals, but we don't have their point of origin.
Okay, now I know that looks bad, but listen, you have to promise this goes nowhere except police places, okay? I mean, you're gonna think I'm being catty about Andrea, and I'm not. I don't judge people. Thing is, she's kind of a party girl with the guys in the band. I mean, not a slut, definitely not a slut. Just hanging out after hours. And you know how it is. I don't think Ray's ex-wife, Jill, was thrilled when she heard about it. Ray and Andrea were starting to move past just partying to something more serious. Jill Wilde? She was great in her day, you know? Bullet Train's first lead singer way back when, in the 80s. Really talented, a real golden oldie. She and Ray, they had a nasty breakup. But you know, I don't think she really ever got over him. She still performs, which I think is so sweet, at a lounge. Here at the casino, as a matter of fact.
She performs here? I must have missed the sign.
Yeah, so did I. Brings in the older crowd. My God, you don't think she could be responsible? Could she have loved Ray so much that she... You don't really think that, do you? That's kind of harsh, isn't it? Obsessed? Todd? Oh, he's harmless. Yeah, sure, he dug her, but he's a roadie with a crush on a lead singer. He couldn't get closer to her than the soundboard. I mean, seriously.
Could Todd Hinckley have known that Andrea was hooking up with the band?
Sure, but what could he do about it? I think he had Andrea all built up in his mind and was probably, you know, disappointed that the object of his affection was pulling the train.
Excuse me.
No autographs, okay? I always sign after the show, but...
We're with the crime lab, Miss Wilde.
Oh, yeah. I was expecting you. About Ray, right?
We're sorry for your loss. Why were you expecting us?
Oh, well, yeah. Todd? Knew him since he was a baby. Anyway, he called and gave me chapter and verse, but this is not a cool time. I've been drowning my sorrows in booze and blackjack with a black coffee antidote that didn't take. I got more witnesses than those Jehovah cats. If I wrote that little bitch a note, it'd be two words long. The second would be you, and you can deduce the first, Columbo. Ugh, next question. I don't know. Why?
We have reason to suspect foul play in the deaths of your ex-husband and the other victims.
Really? You have reason to suspect? and you're wasting your time and mine talking to me. Hey, here's a wild hair of a suggestion. Why don't you go out and find the killer?
You must have been pretty upset when you heard about your ex-husband sleeping with a girl half your age. Who told you about them, Todd?
I don't remember who told me, because it just wasn't that important to me. Who he swaps venereal diseases with nowadays, I could care less. I won't lie and say I'm shedding any tears over that selfish dickweed's death. Hey, I dumped him, by the way. Ancient history.
Must have been a real slap in the face when Bullet Train made a literal show out of finding a new lead singer. I mean, your voice was on every one of their hits. Then they make a comeback without you? You missed the train.
You haven't followed the little train that couldn't, have you? Since I booked, the three of them can't make a sandwich together without being arrested. Huh, which theme park will they appear at next? Oh, the suspense is killing me.
I understand your bitterness. You know, I saw you with the train back in 89. You weren't just the heart and soul of the act. You were the act.
Well, you're a man of rare taste and fine frickin' distinction. You ever been down here at the casino to see what I'm up to post-train? Room's a sellout, night after night, and I am rocking the roof off the joint.
Listen, I know you said no autographs, but I really am a big fan. It's Warwick Brown, two R's and a K.
Blue eyes, you had me at Crime Lab. Whisper in my ear and I'll get you a backstage pass, too.
No, just the autograph. Thanks. You have no idea what this means to me.
Eddie is a disgusting, slimy, backstabbing, self-centered, greedy scumbag. I guess he'd fit right in. Man, just thinking about it makes me lose my appetite. Listen, my head's killing me. Take a hike.
Somehow, I don't think she was taking dictation when she wrote this threat. The blood of the crime scene belonged to a fabulous flashback. Nice job, partner. I'm sure Grissom will want to know about this latest development.
If it has anything to do with our quadruple homicide, I do.
Grissom, hey, my partner just placed the former Bullet Train singer at the crime scene. Her DNA was found on a makeshift coke straw found in the auditorium.
That's probably enough to bring drug charges against her. But it doesn't mean she put an early end to her former band's career.
No, but get this. We found a threatening handwritten note to Andrea Stevenson in her hotel room. Guess who composed it?
I don't have to. I can name that tune in one note. Let's bring in Miss Wilde and get her side of the story.
Evidence linking her to the crime scene, threatening letter from her to one of the Vicks. Let's arrange a gig for her in the interview room and see if she'll sing for us.
What? A stage where I wasn't wanted? Where I was being replaced? Hell no. Why the hell would I?
Ever suffer from nosebleeds?
I don't know what you're getting at.
Evidence at the crime scene puts you there, possibly thanks to a certain expensive habit you have. Any comment?
No, no comment at all, because I have no idea what you're talking about. I do know I was never there, and you know why? Because I didn't want anything to do with those sons of bitches.
So you're saying you never party with those guys anymore? For old time's sake?
Yeah, sure. I get real nostalgic about those has-been jackasses. Always great to get high with a bunch of bring downs. Hey, I grew up a long time ago. You want to find yourself a party girl? Look no farther than Miss Kathy Butterwood Melt.
A handwriting analysis confirms you wrote this note found in Andrea's hotel suite.
You manipulative, lying bastards. Now I know what my autograph means to you. I don't have to talk to you people.
Come on, take us behind the music.
Look. I did write that note for Andrea, but it's not what you think, and that's all I'm gonna say about it.
Miss Wilde, we notice you have some sort of residue on the strap of your dress.
Okay. I got a rough schedule. Multiple shows night after night. Once in a while, I might need a little help before a gig. Understand? Bust me? What good does it do anybody?
We're gonna have to take a sample. It'll just take a second.
Make it quick, would ya? And Blue Eyes? You can forget about that backstage pass.
This matches the chemicals found on Andrew's clothing. Same fire retardant found on the switch inside the echo pedal. Now, how does this fit in?
Hey, what's up? She's on her way to interrogation now.
You know what song I'm gonna sing for you, Jokers? Silent Night. And it ain't even Christmas.
Fine, Ms. Wilde. For now, I'll take a solo. Your ex-husband's on national TV, seeking a younger, sleeker you. Finds one in Andrea Stevenson. You send a note to scare her off, but figuring that won't work, you show up with a fire extinguisher to dampen their hunka-hunka burning love. Afterward, you decide you've had it, so you break into the studio and steal Andrea's echo pedal. You open the pedal, improvise a few revisions, and put it back. The evidence ties you to the scene. Chemical residue connects you with the murder weapon. You wrote a threatening note to one of the victims, providing plenty of motive to ensure your farewell tour starts and ends on death row.
Listen, I get that this looks really, really bad, but you're reading it wrong. Yeah, I wrote that note all right, but I wasn't trying to warn her off Ray. I was trying to get her to leave poor Todd alone. That overgrown kid had been bitching about Andrea to me for weeks, figuring I'd be a sympathetic ear. I mean, Todd was crazy about Andrea from the start, but she thought he was a creep and told him so. And then, after she became a finalist, all of a sudden they're an item? I mean, Todd was close to the band. I figured the bitch had to be using him. Okay, I'm gonna be straight with you guys, even though I might be looking at a drug bust. But murder, that's not me. Yeah, I was there. I'd been drinking, I was high, and I couldn't stop thinking how Todd was getting the short end from that slut Andrea. So I went to the Jet to see him, to reason with the poor jerk.
Jet? Don't you mean Set?
No. They practically lived in that private jet of theirs. That Eddie character? He couldn't put the band up in hotels anymore. Not with their track record of trashing the joints. Don't be too impressed. It's a rental. Talk to Eddie about it. Well, Todd normally crashes there, only when I showed up, Todd had split. Well, Ray and me, we got to talking, and hey, you know how it is. Sometimes old flames rekindle. He reminded me real quick what a self-centered ass he is. We were in each other's arms one minute. Next, I'm tossed off the jet like some damn groupie. I was beyond pissed off. I hauled it right over to that studio and I started tearing that crap apart. I probably lost that straw then. Last straw, right?
The residue we found on your dress was flame retardant. Any idea where it came from?
Not the slightest. Rest of the night, like I said before, I was around the casino. Didn't shower or change or anything. Maybe that retarded stuff was on the jet. Hey, listen, can you give me a pass on the drug thing? This gets out in the papers. I'll lose my lounge gig.
We'll see how your story checks out. We do appreciate your help, and this isn't a vice investigation. But don't go on tour, Ms. Wilde. Only local appearances, okay?
I told you what I know.
Where did you get that stupid idea? Oh, yeah, that ridiculous memo. Come on, man, you know the entertainment media, all the news that's fit to invent. Look, I couldn't fix the contest even if I wanted to, and neither could the band. It's the public who votes and the public who buys the CDs, baby. Supply and demand, and I'll supply whatever junk the idiots demand.
Splitting the profits two ways is better than five.
So you think I staged the band's comeback to bump them off? Come on, man. Do they have you guys take urine tests at CSI? Because you are definitely high. Good, because I didn't do anything.
Still, you must admit that with the band gone, any dispute over the ownership of the songs becomes moot.
The dispute is not moot. It's over. See, the contract the band signed always spells it out. And Bullet Train will be easier to handle dead, frankly.
As a music fan, I'm sorry there won't be any more Bullet Train sides. Under your management, they came into their own musically. No Free Rides is way better than any of the 80s stuff.
Oh, thanks, man. I know I must sound pretty cold. You know, the boys did have talent, or I wouldn't have put up with all the... Anyway, I appreciate the kind words. Too bad our last label didn't agree with you.
Hey, could I snag one of those demo CDs? I'm a big fan.
Yeah, sure, why not? I'll be leaking some of the tracks onto the internet soon anyway, and then getting mad and acting like somebody else leaked it.
There's more to be done with that item before we can process it.
rise and shine in the county slammer. Could be Texas or maybe Alabama. I'm at the end of the bottle. I shot too many, I shot too many. I'm down on my luck, and I ain't got a penny. I shot too many. And when I'm back on the streets, I'll just do it again and again. I shot too many, I shot too many. I shot too many, I shot too many.
Now, why would Eddie be personally checking the band's equipment?
Show's in big trouble, then suddenly it's all over the media with ratings bound to jump, thanks to a few homicides. Band had been threatening to fire him, plus we got his prints on the echo pedal, aka the murder weapon. Take a stroll around that studio, why don't you, and see if you can come away with any catchy tunes.
Eddie, we're ready to look and touch. Here's your warrant.
Do what you have to do and get out of here. You break it, you bought it. Break it, you bought it.
Might belong to a power cord. Looks like a file was downloaded from an audio website, then encrypted. We can recover it in the lab. It's a letter from a private jet charter. A fire extinguisher had been discharged on the aircraft, and they're issuing a fine of $1,360 to Eddie's production company.
Wasn't for me, that's for sure. You know how many musicians and engineers come through here? It could have been any one of them.
This prong was probably torn from the power cord using a pair of pliers or a similar tool.
Yeah, well, this ain't in my contract. Stinkly, back off, creep.
Cut me a break, guys. Eddie says he wants some behind-the-scenes stuff. You know, DVD extras.
Well, here's something extra for you, Toady. And Eddie, too. There won't be any DVD unless Bullet Train releases it. Not after I get through soon until it's this greedy lying ass. Oh, Todd, don't mope. Tell you what, stick around. When your little girlfriend shows up, you can shoot some amateur porn while me and the boys pass her around.
You know, you shouldn't talk about people like that. You guys are... you're evil.
That's close, but not quite a match. But you knew that, right? It's the little details that you're looking for. When you're sure, then ask me. Seems to be the schematics for an echo pedo like the rigged one at the crime scene, which you'll recall had Eddie's fingerprints on it.
I hear you have a new lead on the Rockstar murders.
Eddie, the band's manager. He's got motive and opportunity. I imagine he stands to make more money off of Bullet Train CD sales now that the band is dead.
I imagine you can back that up with evidence?
Well, we know that Eddie was under pressure from the TV execs to fix the contest so that Andrea would win. We have his fingerprints on the echo pedal that was essentially the murder weapon. His computer contained detailed schematics for the altered echo pedal, and the ground prong that was found in his recording studio caused the electrocution.
Nice work. The evidence tells a good story. Are you on your way to see Brass for a warrant?
Yeah. Time to get Eddie in our own recording booth and see where he fits into the mix.
Eddie had the schematics of the echo pedal, which he thoughtfully left his prints on, and now evidence indicates he fooled with the power cords. Let's get the manager-producer over here and see if he can manage to produce an explanation. Before we start, mind if I call you Eddie?
Yes, I do mind.
We need you to help us through a few snags we've run into.
If you know, tell me, 'cause I don't.
That pedal was altered for a shocking reason, and the schematics we found on the computer in your studio would have been very helpful to whoever did it.
Yeah, right. Look, I'm sure this is all very interesting, and when you work it all out, be sure to leave a message on my machine. I have a business to run and to promote, and the entertainment news people happen to be waiting for me at my studio right now.
We're interested in some news, too. As in how that doctored pedal changed the current on Andrea's mic. In your studio, we found this prong that was pried off the power cord on Andrea's mic. Without that prong, the power cord couldn't ground the current, and Andrea and the band took the full jolt.
Right. A tragedy. And you obviously know more about it than I do. Than I care to, really. Our tech Todd's there time to time. Does some AV work at the studio. The band, of course. Kathy and Andrea both recorded there.
Let's see if this melody is familiar. Your show's in the dumper, network's threatening to pull it from the schedule and toss you in the circular file, should the finale tank. The train's threatening to sue you over their best tracks in years, possible CD or two, DVD action, and you decide dying would be a good career move for these ungrateful, overage bad boys. You latch onto that echo pedal and its power cord, download some schematics, and soon you've created some very real buzz for Bullet Train.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Guys, look, back off, okay? Think. Just think for a minute. Bullet Train. Those guys were a pain in the ass. But what rock group is it? They were laying down great sides, and if the TV ratings weren't high enough for the execs, we were still playing to a way bigger audience than the band had seen in years. Why would I want to wreck that train? I can't explain how that stuff got in my studio, but I do remember the morning of rehearsal, Todd came by the studio. The stage set had been trashed in the night, and I was so furious. I was so upset I ran over there to check out the damage. I must have touched that pedal then. Take it up for a spin if it'll get this over with. Probably that psycho bitch Jill Wilde. Not that I can prove it. I mean, you know she's Ray's ex-ball and chain, right? And she was bent out of shape, the band taking on a new lead singer in such a public way.
Damn. Let's get to work. Nice job catching all those bugs. Let's get back to work.
We don't have permission to search this yet. You'll want a different tool for that.
And now we know how our flame retardant entered the game. Nothing interesting on this frame. Nothing interesting on this frame. Nothing interesting on this frame. What do we have here? Pedal with the missing screw. Printed pedal diagram. Todd may have given his life to Bullet Train, but it could be Bullet Train gave their lives to Todd. Nice work.
He's on his way to interrogation now.
What?
Todd, you surprise me. You're not just a backstage boy. You're a player. A beauty like Andrea, man. Surprised the tape didn't melt. All it lacks is audio and maybe some funky 70s disco.
Cut me a break, guys. I said Andrea and me hit it off, so I wanted a video to remember it by. Well, if that makes me a pervert, I got a lot of company. It's not like I was gonna put it on the internet or anything.
That echo pedal and the schematics in your quarters made it onto your tape and gave us something to remember you by.
No, no way. That's a fuzzy, awful homemade video. You could never see stuff that small.
Maybe Andrea dug you, or maybe she was using you. But you didn't care. Either way, you jumped from stalker to rocker of her world. Only small world, the rest of the band was, too. So you rig the pedal, but forget to put back the screw. The boys blasting that fire extinguisher, while the two of you were making it, that pushed you over. That erased any doubt, and the plan went from half daydream to full reality.
No.
Afterward, you went to Eddie's studio, and as soon as he left, planted evidence against him. What went wrong, Todd? Was it finding out Andrea was riding the entire train? Or did you decide if you couldn't have her? Nobody could.
It wasn't supposed to be that way. I had no way of knowing those stupid bastards would take their boots off and get into it like that, holding on to her and her mic and the mic stand. Hell. But they liked her more than Kathy, didn't they? Wanted Andrea to win. She put the idea in my head. She told me if Andrea was gone, if she were around, I could really be part of the band. Only with Andrea, I'd always be just a nothing, always a nobody. Then she said frame Eddie and be the train's manager, and none of those guys would ever push me around again. No, no, you're not listening! Kathy! Kathy! That's not Andrea on the tape, it's Kathy! Kathy's the one that slept with me. Kathy's the one who slept with the band, not Andrea. Andrea was... She had more class than that. She was good. Too good for the train. Too good for me.
Okay, so Kathy dresses up like Andrea for a little role play in the hay. Then Kathy explains how you can have it all. Just reverse a little electrical switch and take Andrea out of the game.
Doesn't look like Kathy on the tape.
It's her, all right. She said she found a memo in Eddie's studio about rigging the contest against her. She knew I was in a bad way over Andrea. So she started coming on to me. When, you know, she was through servicing the band. She'd wear Andrea's clothes and put on a wig, and it was like I always dreamed. And Kathy said it would be like this all the time for me if she won. She made me feel like a winner for once. I never meant to hurt the boys. Suddenly they take off their shoes like Andrea, and I couldn't stop it. It was a total accident, a nightmare right in front of my face. Yeah, they could be mean, but I loved their music, and they were my whole life for as long as I can remember. I just wanted to be in a place where they would respect, where they'd have to respect me. Go ahead, arrest me. I deserve it for stupidity. But you've got to stop her. Kathy's the evil one. Look, that jet is mic'd to record audio for the TV show. There's a drawer just under the TV bar on the plane where the daily tapes are stored. You're gonna find tape 23 real interesting, especially about 3 hours in.
This is what you want, isn't it? This is what you've dreamed of. I'm the dream of her. And you can have that dream anytime, baby. Anytime. If you get rid of the nightmare, the her that won't give you the time of day. And I'll be her for you, for the band. And they won't laugh at you anymore. Not when you're the manager. Just do it. Do it. Rig the pedal. Smart man like you. It's easy. Use those schematics. You can figure it out in a second.
Surprise, Stinkly!
Well, that confirms Todd's story. He was coerced into rigging the echo pedal. Let's do a voice comparison to be sure it's Kathy. Nice work. That's the bona fide imitation Andrea, Kathy Contanta. So it seems Todd never did have a relationship with Andrea, except in his fevered imagination. So he settled on the runner-up. Let's bring her in.
Voice comparison proves that Kathy is the one who sexually coerced Todd into committing murder. Nice work. Without it, she might have skated.
And he's named you as an accomplice.
I'm not surprised Todd was responsible. But you better think again about trying to bring me into it. That lunatic acted alone.
Actually, it was a duet. And we have one of your most spirited performances on tape. See how many notes it takes you to name this tune.
Just do it. Do it. Rig the pedal. Smart man like you. It's easy. Use those schematics. You can figure it out in a second. Well, that's not me. That's Andrea.
A reasonable facsimile of Andrea.
but forensic voice analysis confirms the voice is yours.
No way. It's not me.
You may want to sing a different tune after you hear our rendition. Todd had a major yen for Andrea, who the band had pegged for their new lead singer. She snubbed Todd, and you stepped in, helped him live out his fantasy. And in the heat of that, you offered him so much more, a position of respect with his precious train. All he had to do was arrange an accident for Andrea, the woman who spurned him, plus help pin it on Eddie, eliminating him from the show before he could eliminate you.
You downloaded and printed the echo pedal schematics on Eddie's computer so Todd could alter it. You sold Todd by plying him with the loving attention Andrea refused him. You removed the competition and a bonus track, the band that spurned you.
You become Train's last lead singer with those train tracks in the can and go on to a high-profile solo career. Sweet.
I want a lawyer. You people are trying to railroad me.
Well, that's a new one, Kathy.
What do you mean?
First time I heard you sing the blues. Well, those hard-rockin' dinosaurs may have had careers near extinction, but they, and the young and talented Andrea, just didn't deserve to meet Elvis so soon. On the flip side, Kathy and Todd only have one song to sing from now on, The Jailhouse Rock. Good working with you.
All right, here's your evaluation. For evidence, you found everything there was to find. For hints, you didn't need any at all. And at the end of the day, you followed the evidence to a clear conclusion. I can't argue with that. Outstanding work. You've investigated every possible angle on this case. I'm giving you the highest mark available. Doesn't happen often, but I'm very impressed. And by the way, thank you for all the new specimens you found for my collection. I'm recommending you for an extra bonus. Great hunting.